So one of my favorite things about creating these photo editing tutorials for you is that it inspires me to find interesting ways to use the tools that we have at our disposal. Just because a tool's primary function is to do X doesn't mean that a little outside of the box thinking can't also make it do Y. So for this tutorial, I want to show you two different ways that you can use the trusty Radial Gradient tool in Lightroom to apply some really creative edits to your landscape photos. Now, typically, I use the Radial Gradient to create custom shaped vignettes, especially when I want to draw the viewer's eye to a specific subject or a specific area of my photo. But there are a few other ways that this handy tool can help you accentuate your photos. So let's dive in. But before we do this tip, this will work exactly the same regardless of whether you're using Lightroom Desktop, Lightroom Classic, Lightroom Mobile, or even Lightroom Web. So this is going to be a lot of fun. All right, so I want to show you two different ways to use the Radial Gradient tool, which is listed in the masking tools over here under this icon. Now, just to show you, this is a photo I took at Trillium Lake in Oregon, and I already applied some edits. If I hit the backslash key, you can see this is the original photo, and this is the edited. And if you look through the editing pane here, there's really not much that I did, mostly some tone and curve adjustments in a custom light balance. So really not much. But what I want to show you is how you can use the Radial Gradient to do two specific things, or rather to accentuate two things in a photo like this. So the techniques that I'm going to show you, they work best for landscape photos when there's either like some fog or there is very strong directional light and you want to accentuate that. So again, if we look at the photo here, you can see we have both of those things. This photo will allow me to illustrate both of the techniques. We have fog on the horizon over here. And we have the sun is still, this is just after sunrise, so the sun is still kind of low in the sky, and you can see the way the direction of the light's kind of coming like this. And so I want to accentuate that by adding a nice glow over here, and I also want to bring out the fog, especially along here. I'm not as concerned about the fog in the foreground. I really want to kind of bring it out here, but I also don't want to affect the borders. And so this is how I'll use the Radial Gradient tool. And this is going to be kind of a short tutorial, but it's a lot of fun. I was excited to get this out to you because I think this will get, the more you learn how to use these tools in different ways, I think the more enjoyment you'll get out of apps like Lightroom. So the first thing we're going to do is let's go to the masking tools here. And again, the Radial Gradient tool is available in all flavors of Lightroom. So you can do this regardless of where you are. And so let's start by accentuating the fog here, kind of on the bank, like around the horizon here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select Radial Gradient, and then I'm just going to make a really, really wide and long selection. So you can see it's very, very narrow, and it's very wide. And we can even zoom out here. So let's zoom out to like 25% so you can see just how wide it is. It doesn't have to be that wide, but I do want it to extend beyond the image here. So we'll put it right around there. The other thing that I'm going to do is I want a really, really soft transition. And so that means I need to increase the feather. Now you can increase the feather by either clicking on this little dot over here and then dragging in or out. So if I drag it in, that makes the feather larger. Or if I drag it out, it makes the feather smaller. So I want a really large feather. The other way to do that is by using this feather slider. So you can see I can adjust the feather that way as well. Now, to accentuate the fog, there are two primary components. The first is using the dehaze slider. So dehaze is typically used to accentuate things like the sky. It'll add contrast, it'll add blue in the sky, but it'll also add definition to the clouds when you add a positive dehaze. So watch, if I add a positive dehaze, we're actually removing the haze. It's doing what it's supposed to do, but I don't want that. What I want is to pair this Radial Gradient with a negative dehaze. So watch, let's actually go to fit. Let's make this image larger here. And I'll go ahead and I'll make a negative dehaze. And do you see how the fog is getting more pronounced? Like it's getting thicker. And to me, this looks awesome. But we can also pair this with a simple exposure adjustment. So let's make it a little bit brighter as well. Something like that. We can also open up the highlights a bit. And that looks really good. And so now you can see how that fog really looks. It just looks like it has more presence. If we click on the little eye icon here, you can see how this is without the radial gradient, and then this is with the radial gradient and the adjustments made to that selection. Now we can, of course, do a few other things. Like let's say we want to give it a bit of a cooler tone. I can move the temperature slider to the left here to give it a little bit of a blue tint. makes it feel a little bit cooler. And you can continue to have fun and refine it, but I just wanted to show you really quickly how you can use the radial tool with dehaze to accentuate fog. And it doesn't have to be fog along a horizon. It could be fog in any part of a photo. Now, let's go ahead. I like to keep order with my masks. So what I'm going to do is click on the ellipsis here and go to rename, and I'm going to call this fog layer. So I know that this particular mask is for the fog. Now let's go ahead and I'm going to show you another way to use the radial gradient. And this is also a lot of fun. I mentioned how the sun is kind of coming at this lower angle and you have this really pleasing kind of side light and the tops of the trees are being lit. Let's say I want to accentuate that. Let's say I want to add a beautiful warm glow to this whole area here. Well, it kind of could work because we see that there's already fog. There's a little bit of fog you can kind of see in between the tree lines here. And so I want to accentuate that. So this is how I use a radial gradient to do that. The first thing I do is I zoom out a lot. Like I'm going to go to like 25% here. In fact, I might even go wider to like 12%. And the reason why I want to do that is because similar to the radial gradient for the fog, I'm going to add a radial gradient, but it's going to be well outside of the border of the photo. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new mask. And just like before, let's select radial gradient. And I'm going to make another giant selection. This one's going to be a lot rounder. And I'm going to start bringing it into the image here. So you can see with the overlay how it almost, because I have the color as this kind of yellow orange, you can almost get an idea of what that glow effect will look like. So I'm going to start bringing it down and over. I'm going to pull it back here because it's spilling a bit too much. So right around there, it looks good as kind of like the starting point. You can see how almost all of the mask is outside of the photo. There's only a little bit that's bleeding into the photo, and that's what I want. So let's go ahead. I'm going to click on fit so we can see the photo here. And just like before, I'm going to go ahead and apply a negative dehaze. So let's go ahead. And as I do that, you see how you were getting that kind of nice glow. And I can see that I actually probably put the mask too far away. So let's bring this dehaze slider a little bit stronger. Let's zoom back out to 12% and let's introduce it right over there. And see what that looks like, maybe a little bit more right around there and a little bit further down. You can see how as I move it in and out, you can see that glow appear. So I can kind of really refine exactly where I want it. So somewhere right around there. Now let's go ahead, let's bring it back to fit. And what I also want to do is add a little bit of warmth. So think of the dehaze as kind of like controlling the strength of the actual glow or the fog. And then you want to apply other controls to make the characteristics of that glow or that fog match your intent. So I want to warm it up. Now you could use a temperature slider here and it does a pretty good job here of warming it up. But if you want to really accentuate it with the point curve here, normally you'll be on kind of the RGB point curve. But if you go to the blue channel, and if I drop a pin here in the highlights and I start moving it, you can see how it gets this really nice warm glow, which is what I want. Something right around that looks really nice. And we can toggle that so you can see what a beautiful effect it has. And it does a nice job of contrasting kind of the cooler tone of the fog up here with the warmer tone of the glow from the sun. So let's go ahead and rename this here to Sun Glow. And you can see if we toggle both of the masks, this is basically the edited photo without any localized adjustments. And then here we were able to use the radial gradient to apply a fog and a sun glow. So fog layer and the sun glow layer. So like I mentioned, this is like one of my favorite things to do, to take the tools that we have and think of different ways to use them. It's just a lot of fun. It's also creatively rewarding for me to think of ways that I can accentuate the look of my photo using tools that might not have been designed for that particular purpose. I don't know, it's just kind of fun to do it, and I love sharing it with you. So with that, if you do want to learn more about landscape photo editing and developing a really tight editing workflow using Lightroom, please check out my course called Lightroom Landscapes. It's got over 4.5 hours of easy-paced lessons, and it'll just help you with all of these kinds of approaches to getting a really tight, efficient, and creative workflow with your landscape photos. Of course, if you found this video helpful, a thumbs up is always appreciated, as is clicking on the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.